Good afternoon, everybody. We all know the 80s fashion trends that were often touted. Let's think leg warmers, plastic bracelets, scrunchies, and others. And that's all great. However, there were a few that made no sense that were pretty strange. And so today, let's remember 10 weird 80s fashion trends. First off, boom boxes. Before portable speakers, before the iPod, before the Walkman and MP3 players, there was the boombox.
Just where is the future? The things we've done and said. Let's just push the button, we'd be better off dead. Cause I hate you. And I berate you. And
excuse me.
I can't wait to get
that noise.
To you. The sins of all our fathers being dumped on us, the sun. The only choice we're given is how many megatons.
Mind stopping that damn noise?
And I say screw you! And I hope you're blue too. We're all bloody worthless.
While technically a piece of electronics, the boombox or ghetto blaster, depending on where you lived, was indeed a part of fashion. According to Dolce & Gabbana, it was initially introduced to American market during the mid-1970s. The boombox's popularity surged in the 80s, becoming almost a status symbol. With the change in musical genres, these portable radios became increasingly larger, at some point even reaching the size of a suitcase. And now we kind of go the other way, the smaller the better, at least where electronics is concerned. While usually powered by an AC adapter, they could also be powered by a bunch of bulky batteries. Let's take this example. Powered by 6 D-cell batteries, this initial model included a handle and was fully portable to record on the go, although only lasting a few hours. And while rechargeable batteries did exist, most did not have them. Boomboxes didn't reach the USA until the late 1970s. An interview on NPR's music documentary, The History of the Boombox, hip-hop historian Fab Five Freddy describes how New York hip-hop culture popularized the use of the boombox.
People that were big fans of music at the time were into higher fidelity, better quality sound, bass, mid-range, and treble. So as they listened to what the consumer, what the young hip kid on the streets of New York wanted, we wanted bass. Like that feel of the boom, boom, boom was exciting, you know? And so they began to give more bass and more boom.
Next up, Hypercolor. Have you ever wanted your clothes to change color exactly where you were sweating or where someone touched you? No? Well, we did in the early 1990s. As we left the 1980s and headed to the future of the 90s, 1991 would give us Hypercolor clothing. Hypercolor was a line of clothing, mainly t-shirts and shorts, that changed color with heat. However, apparel company Genera struck gold with Hypercolor. Their line of thermochronic apparel that was dyed with a patented process that allowed the cotton fabric to react to spikes in the wearer's body temperature was a huge hit. While color-changing items were not entirely new, think mood rings back in the day, Genera became the exclusive licensee of Hypercolor technology in the United States and began a heavy promotional campaign in the 1990s. Blanketing MTV and teen magazines like 17 and Thrasher with print ads for the color shifting apparel that read Hypercolor, Hypercool. And just as quickly as it became a hit, it would also fade away, kinda like the fabric on the t-shirts. Hypercolor success came at a price. There was a shortage of the dyes used and a backlog of orders that needed to be filled. Genera added employees and new manufacturing facilities in their home base of Seattle, but would end up only meeting about half of the demand. By the time production ramped back up, consumer enthusiasm for Hypercolor was beginning to wane. Next up is the Swatch watch.
Swatch him! Ha ha ha! Swatch him! Now the hands on the Swatch are all persistent, and the Swatch is water and shock resistant. Swatch him! Ha ha ha! Swatch him! Swatch! The new wave in Swiss watches. Swatch! Swatch!
Here is the one I have, and it's still in pretty good shape. Every teen seemed to own one of these watches, You know, back in the day when people still needed to tell time on their wrist. And if you still happen to have one of these swatches kicking around, you can get big money for these 80s icons. For example, the Kiki Picasso watch can sell for up to $22,600. Or Andrew Logan's jellyfish watch, which can sell over $10,000. So maybe check your drawers to see if you have one sitting in there. Unlike many of the 80s fashions, this was a serious company and a maker of fine timepieces. From Switzerland and ran by Nicholas G. Hayek from 1928 to 2010, the Swatch Group achieved world renown as the crown jewel of the watchmaking industry. In the early 1980s, Mr. Hayek led the company's firm from a severe crisis. His decisive leadership was critical to the launch of the Swatch watch in 1983, and subsequently drove the continuous development and improvement of all Swatch Group brands. If that was not enough, you could also buy accessories for your Swatch watch in the form of protection. You could get a Swatch guard in a couple different varieties, which were bands to cover and protect your valuable timepiece.
Swatch!
Shutter shades, sometimes referred to as Venetian blinders, examples were featured in the music videos for Glittering Prize by Simple Minds in 1982 and Obsession by Animotion in 1984. They were also popularized by professional wrestler Macho Man Randy Savage,
snap into a Slim Jim,
which he wore before many of his matches as well as his promos. While they didn't really serve much of a purpose or protection or, you know, very good visibility, you did look like a The Wendy's Jazz Cap.
160 big classic combos with Coke.
Yeah! Oh, no! It's the Ocean Beach Geriatric Surfboard and Precision Marching Surfboard Drill Team.
March into Wendy's and get a Jazz Cap for $1.99 with any purchase.
You may have missed this one as they were popular for about 1 month. A promotion offering from Wendy's basically let you have the equivalent of a Hawaiian shirt on your head. Kids would roam the halls and schools with these hats on, at least until a teacher demanded you remove your hat, because for some reason hats were not allowed in class in the 80s. I don't think that's the case anymore, but since I have not been to school in many years, I could be completely wrong. These rad hats were yours for only $1.99 with purchase. You remember this short-lived fad?
With any sandwich or salad purchase, but hurry before time runs out.
Jazz caps!
Because jazz caps are the ticket. Get them now at Wendy's.
Bum equipment. B-U-M. Bum equipment t-shirts were the thing to have as an 80s kid who wanted to be a fashion hit. While the company is still around and has exchanged hands a few times, the 80s is where it reigned. Many now look down on the brand as cheap. However, it was everywhere in the 1980s. Fingerless gloves. Fingerless gloves became a fashion statement in the 1980s, made iconic by celebrities such as Billy Idol and Madonna, and for you heavy metal fans, add some spikes onto the gloves and they were yours too. Technically, the lace fingerless gloves can be traced back as early as the 19th century. However, in the 80s, it was a culmination of many influences. And for some reason, we had an obsession with cutting things off in the 80s. Think leg warmers, which were basically half pants slash socks. I don't know. Or, for example, cut-off jeans, or a cut-off denim jacket which you could turn into a vest. Some trace it back to the New Romantics. When the New Romantics hit the scene, they often wore a lot of lace shirts, and to finish off that lace look quite nicely, they wore a pair of fingerless gloves that matched their outfit. Levi's 501 jeans. They were really the best thing ever. The button fly is superior to the zipper, and that is a fact. They would come stiff and pale until your first wash. They would shrink to fit and take on that more familiar dark blue color. And you better tuck in your t-shirt, because you have to display that 501 back patch with honor. They also had a series of animated commercials that propelled the brand and the jeans to 80s icon status. So let me know, are you team button fly or team zipper?
Bye.
the white jacket. For around a year, every preppy popular kid wore one jacket. This one, made popular by the show Miami Vice and Don Johnson, it inspired the hallways of middle and high school kids everywhere. Add a switchblade comb, some nice shades, and you look totally rad. We even had a fashion show at my middle school where the Miami Vice theme song would play and kids would walk down the aisle wearing these bad boys. Nowadays, it's more of a Halloween costume. It was very popular and trendy back in the 1980s. And the hair poof. Grab the Aquanet and spray away. Make that hair big, make it tall, and be sure to add one tiny extra step. While yes, 80s hair in itself is something of an enigma, for a time there was an added step of adding a small, snowball-sized poof right in the front. And now you are ready for a night out at the movies, checking out Spaceballs in the drive-in theater. Just make sure you give yourself a little spritz of exclamation perfume to finish off the night. Now, there are plenty more fashion trends out there that we haven't covered. Do you remember or know of any other 80s trends that were a little off and a little odd? We would definitely appreciate a like and subscribe and the bell notifications and all that other clickety-click stuff that you can do. But for now, let's wrap this one up. I want to thank you so much for watching. My name is Kevin, and as always, have a wonderful, wonderful day.
Platinum fever, that's all we have. We have TV shows that kept us up all night. It's all right here. Subscribe to Retro Renaissance Channel.
Sticker. Show us some of your stickers.
Like this? We only spent like $3 on stickers.
I know, and you only get a few, but...